is brought to you by the Hexagon Bar and Memory Lanes, Willie's American Guitars, Hot Comics, Blarney's Pub and Grill, CC Club, Renegade's Bar and Grill. This is MRTC.
Hey, Patrick here with MRTC. I'm here with the band Hurt, Paul and Jay Lauren from Hurt. Hurt's going to play yet another show. The shows just keep mounting for you guys. Volume 1 comes out in like 2006, fall of 07. You got Volume 2, and you guys have been on the road, I think, for 2.5 years straight now.
We have pretty much. We only stopped to record.
Yeah, with the exception of the recording on the second record, which is about 6 months.
Right.
So we still weren't, like, still working constantly. There's no, like, break, still, you know, playing every day. So it's been...
Yeah, I think we've taken approximately 3 or 4 days off in this part of the year, and that's just been to travel to another location. I mean, every day is a little bit of a blur. I mean, yesterday we were in Des Moines, day before that we were in Cedar Rapids, and all of these shows have been really, really good, with the exception of just a couple. They've either been sold out or right there close to the brim, and you definitely can't complain about that. We had the wonderful fortune of being on probably the biggest rock tour this year, and our friends in all three of the bands, you know, asked us to come on, and we were delighted to play with 3 Days Grace and Seether and Breaking Benjamin. So that was a really good time, and we finished that up, let the boys from Neverset take over, so they got this leg of the tour. We were kind of sorry that we missed, you know, but anyway, you gotta let it go sometime, and we had to play our own shows so, you know, we can play longer sets that way.
Right.
You know, fans want to hear it, they want to see it.
Well, the Target Center's sound sucks anyway, so you probably saved yourself. Maybe next time around.
Well, that's the bad part about some of the big shows. Usually the sound does, you know.
The big arenas, they can blow, yeah. But in town here, it's XL Energy Center. It's great sound. It's the brand new building with the Wild Play and all that. But Target Center, that place has been around for 18 years. I still haven't figured it out. It's just a lot of people hear the shows at the Target Center. Sorry, Target Center people. God, I just realized
all the
I'm
arenas,
trashing them.
Most of the arenas are all designed for sports events, not for, like, loud music. So it's so booming, it just doesn't, you know, the acoustics in there are not designed for rock concerts.
And we did the show with 93X at the Myth, and the sound was really good in that place. It's a new, you know, clean facility. It's probably the nicest medium-sized rock venue in the country.
God, you know, for as hard as you work, your memory is just awesome. I see you a couple of times.
Unfortunately, it is. That's why I drink so much.
What's the drink of choice?
I drink whiskey instead.
What, are you talking like Jameson, Jack Daniels, whatever?
I prefer Jim Beam or anything that's an actual bourbon, but, you know, this guy here, he's got to be the, you know, cliche rock star guy.
I like Jack Daniels. Jack Daniels, Jim Beam, it's like Pepsi and Coke for me, and I like...
Okay.
I prefer one over the other.
Yeah, whichever.
I could drink either.
Yeah, whichever.
But I just put up with him.
But I'm actually been drinking
so well.
Gin lately.
Gin?
Yeah.
Oh, gin and juice?
No, gin and tonic.
Just gin
I swear
tonic.
To God, I know he switched to gin. I know why.
Does it affect
him? Lay off my stash.
It's because I won't drink gin, and that's probably why. So he's always got it laying around.
Consummation and also the Black Market EP.
Yeah, these two things were pretty much like surprises. We got a lot of requests for live stuff, you know, because the band, people keep saying, is amazing live, and people wanted to get that on tape. So we just made a CD and burned it, and that's the Black Market EP. It also has two acoustic versions of our songs in there. Now, that's not a widely distributed CD, so you'd have to go to our website to get it if you're not at the show.
Right.
The other thing is the Reconsummation. Was a prior album called The Consummation. That's what really got this whole ball rolling.
Mm-hmm.
But unfortunately, a fellow was printing them and he was selling them for upwards of $170, and our fans were paying it, and I just didn't like that.
No.
And you know, this really gave me a chance to just get the album remastered, make it sound better, really make it complete, and you know, fix all the problems and flaws that I hadn't gotten to before. Yeah. So I said, never been a better time than right now, and yeah. We've just put it back out again.
And you've talked about the record. Record music's changing, bands are changing. I mean, that's not the side that we really want as bands. You know, fans paying $170.
No, that's not what I want. I would never ask somebody to do
that. But I read in a recent interview you were talking a little bit how bands should just write what they feel.
They have to.
Things like that.
They have to.
Instead of just writing to the label.
Yeah, I don't understand why that would even happen. That's just compromising like the creativity. And, you know.
If you do that, you're not. I mean, this is a ridiculous thing to do for a living. We're coming up on year 9 of Hurt. And you know, and we are broke as hell. You would not believe it, but we are. Yeah. And if we were just doing something cheesy, I don't know how I could live with myself. You know, working the hours we do and doing
that much heart and soul and effort and time and everything into it to something that you don't fully stand behind or you know like doing, then it's just a complete waste of your time and fans' time because they're not you know getting music that you actually.
I mean, think of, you know, if you just want to be cold and logistic about it, think about it like a small business owner. You know, that requires a lot of work, requires a lot of dedication for years. And, you know, typically small businesses don't make money for a long time. But think of it, if the small business was not a business the person wanted to do, you know, it's like he wants to own a restaurant, right? But instead he opens up a stationery store. That's going to kind of take a little
it's
bit out
be
of you.
16 hours of why the hell am I doing
right,
this?
Right, and then
all
eventually
day?
you're eating pistol.
Right. So. Do what you love, write what you love, perform what you love.
Exactly.
And you actually said something, too, in a recent interview. I'll get to you in a minute. I keep asking Jake questions. But you said something I've thought about for a long time, because I'll listen to, like, some kind of song that's not a rock song, and some buddy of mine's like, why are you listening to that, you know? Nothing Compares to You or something by Sinead O'Connor. And I'm like, it's a song that evokes an emotion in me.
Yeah.
That's what I think a good song is, and I recently read that you think the same way.
I absolutely think the same way.
It could be country or pop or whatever,
it
as long
really,
as it moves you.
It really could. I mean,
even gospel.
for those of you that you know what I do, I play classical, and there's elements of country and a little bit of a Virginia blues in there, which is kind of a dead style of playing.
Right.
And obviously there's rock, and you know, people hear whatever they want, but down to the end of it, music's just music, and it's really difficult to just put words onto what it is because it is the way it is.
Right.
And you can't just talk about it. You got to do it.
Exactly.
Like, personally, I like Seal.
Yeah.
Uptown Bar, May 17th, which is a Saturday, at 9 p.m., 21 plus, $5.
Calendar.
We'll be right back.
What happens for Hurt this summer, maybe in the next fall? I know you just did two albums in 2 years. Is there going to be a third one? Not called Volume 3, I imagine. But
no.
There will be a third one maybe a couple years down the road. You're going to take some time.
Volume 2 has got a lot of life left in it. And unfortunately, Volume 1 did too. And you know, people kind of moved on. They just wanted Volume 2 so badly. We did it. And you know, we need to tour off of Volume 2 for a lot longer because
a couple more singles on there, right?
Relentless touring schedule of ours.
I mean, it might be to our detriment, but we're a band that expends all of our resources on making an album. Mm-hmm. So you know, you got to get it back, and you got to make sure that the next album you do is better than that. And you'd really be shortchanging yourself and the fans if you didn't do that.
Right. Well, keep your eyes open for Hurt. They might be on the road again. You guys have been here four or five times.
Yep.
It's amazing. We can almost start calling you a local band.
Yeah.
But you guys like Minnesota?
I love Minnesota. I used to have that thing there.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I got it here when I was on a business trip a long time ago.
Oh, there you go.
So I come spend time here from time to time.
Yeah, no, definitely. When you got more time, play another gig here.
Love to visit here when it's not freezing.
Yeah, I was just going to say, you know, it's like 54
today. We
tend
to come to the states most north when it's wintertime.
Yeah.
And then we save summer dates for Florida.
Yeah, when it's sweltering hot, just so we can really feel the pain.
Stop releasing your albums in the fall, then you have to tour all winter.
Oh, crap.
Just music 101.
Why didn't I think of that?
Yeah, so next CD, release it in the spring, and then get a couple days. We'll go fishing, dolphin, chasing tail, whatever you guys
want. That sounds like a great time. In fact, I could really use, you know, a little bit of clean entertainment for a change.
Yeah.
Just maybe sitting out on a boat and fishing. Reminds me of that Lynyrd Skynyrd song.
We did that one day. We had a day off a long time ago. I went out fishing for a day. It was quite fun, and you know.
Our guitar tech caught a minnow.
I think it was a guppy.
Well, we were gonna fry it and make him eat it.
Bring some of those bottles that you like. You bring a gin, you bring some whiskey, and then if you don't catch any fish, you catch a buzz.
There
it's still a good
go.
Day off, right?
Exactly.
That's Patrick with MRTC here with the band Hurt. Definitely check them out if you've not seen them live yet. Volumes 1 and 2. And a couple of their other EPs and side little deals going on right there that you heard about earlier. But definitely check out Hurt. If you haven't seen them live, you're missing out. Volumes 1 and 2 are out in stores right now. Jay.
Thank you for having us. Good to see you again.
Paul.
Hey, thank you very much.
Thanks again, guys.
So the sun fades and the lights break and the spark is blown.
If you're in a band and have a video or would like to be featured on MRTC, contact us at mrtc.tv. Thanks for watching MRTC. Please support these wonderful sponsors. The Hexagon Bar. Memory Lanes. Willie's American Guitars. Hot Comics. Blarney's Pub and Grill. CC Club, Renegades Bar and Grill.